Raptor high stakes, but they'll have to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Tamarkin.
Dynamic duo of Roddy here, and welcome everyone to Press Your Luck. We are television's most competitive game, and what do you say we meet the competitors who are going to be vying for the big bucks today on Press Your Luck, starting with our first player, Corey Caulfield.
Yay!
Hiya, Corey. Now, where are you from, Corey?
I'm from Wooloowin, Wyoming. Yay!
And you were saying no one from Wyoming gets on TV?
I have never seen anyone but Kirk Gowdy on TV, and I'm here to represent the whole
of Wyoming.
Of Wyoming.
All right.
Yeah.
Good luck to you.
Thanks, Peter.
Corey, and we have our champion with us today, Sansi Beck, with $5,835. Sansi, how's it feel to have some bucks?
It's great.
Now you won the trip to London, right? What are you gonna do with the trip? Is that gonna be kind of a honeymoon, you think, maybe?
I think it might be.
Might be. That's it. All right. Well, let's see if you can get some money today to match the trip, all right? Good luck to you. Our next player is Bob Gordon. Hiya, Bob.
Hi, Peter.
Now, Bob, where are you from?
I'm from Malibu, California.
From Malibu. And you had an unusual honeymoon, did you?
Well, yes. My in-laws never did trust me, so they came along on the honeymoon. And yes, they did. And they actually arranged to have twin beds for myself and my wife in South America. They were next door and the whole time.
How long have you been married, Bob?
6 years.
Are they still with you?
They're Malibu people. They keep an eye on me. They do.
You have any children?
One.
Oh, you made it.
Yeah, right. Practice makes perfect.
Well, I'm glad to see it, Bob. Snuck one by him, as it were. All right. Good luck to you. You know how we play this game. I'll ask you questions. You'll give me answers. A buzz-in answer gets you 3 spins. A multiple-choice answer, 1 spin. Are you ready? Here we go. Some people drink coffee and tea morning, afternoon, and night. But what we want to know is during which of those times is the caffeine least apt to have an upsetting effect on your body? Sansi?
Morning.
Is the correct answer morning, afternoon, or evening? Corey?
Afternoon.
Afternoon, says Corey. Bob, what do you think?
Morning.
Morning. Well, the correct answer is afternoon. Corey gets a spin. Yep. Here we go with number 2. Which country was the first to send a woman into space? Bob.
Soviet Union.
Is the correct answer the Soviet Union, USA, or China? Corey?
Soviet Union.
And what do you think, Sansi?
Soviet Union.
Yeah, the first woman in space was Russian.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Corey goes to 2. Sansi, 1, and Bob gets 3 spins. And here we go with the 3rd question. Most Americans who have ever picked up a history book should immediately know this. Which president called Mount Vernon his home? Sansi.
Washington.
Is the correct answer Washington, Jefferson, or Hamilton, Corey?
Washington.
And we'll go over to Bob.
Washington.
Washington. Mount Vernon was the home of George Washington. Corey goes to 3, Nancy to 4, and Bob to 4. Here is the 4th question. 3 ounces of lean beef, skinless chicken, or veal. Which has the most cholesterol? Corey.
Beef.
All right. Is the correct answer beef, veal, or chicken? Sansi?
Veal.
Veal, says Sansi. Let's go over to Bob.
Could you repeat the question?
Sure. 3 ounces of lean beef, skinless chicken, or veal. Which has the most cholesterol?
I'll say beef.
Beef. Well, you'll find out something interesting. You'll find more cholesterol in veal.
Oh.
Yes. Corey says 3. Sansi goes to 5, and Bob goes to 4. Just rolling your chance to turn those things into bucks, so hang in there, we're coming right back. Woo!